Welcome back, everybody. First of all, Merry Christmas, and I hope you like my tree I'm going to build. But today's episode is a special one, like we do every one for Christmas. Let's go back through memory lane and see all the computers that I've built to this point, including my personal one, the Danny 4SFX, called Ryzen Judge, plus all the computers I built for the channel, friends, clients, you name it. So, let's begin. As I was saying, let's start the countdown. The first computer I ever built with my own two hands, picking and selecting all the parts myself and doing a lot of research, was the Penumbra build. In this one I had the dual core. Back then the best CPU to get was the E8400 CPU, a Gigabyte board and the famous Asus 8800 GT. And this one had like the Glaciator cooler, which was way better than the stock single slim fan one they came with. Plus I always wanted that Alienware case, since why I had this Ridemax Ninja one. With this computer I think I only upgraded the video card to a GTX 470 because I needed that to finish Crysis 3. Then the next one was, as I called it, the Blood Ravens chapter, because everything was kinda red, I went for like a red theme. This is when I got the Sandy Bridge, the 2700K, with an Asus Gen 5 motherboard and the GTX 760 because I wanted to try SLI. Hence why I had like a 1200 watt power supply from Seasonic. But I didn't get a chance to do the SLI because a new case and a new era was on the dawn, the small four factor case that started with the M1. This one I called the Mini Decadence, and in here I just reused the CPU but everything else I upgraded, and I think I had a GTX 470 Ti so I can finish Witcher 3. I had this one for a year or two and then the famous Danny 4SFX, the V1, came out, so I said okay, I need to move everything in there, and I took advantage and upgraded everything. So I got the Corsair 600 SFX power supply that I still use today. I upgraded the motherboard to the legendary Impact 7 one because that was the only ITX motherboard that could let me use an M.2 drive to use its full 4x bandwidth. I upgraded the CPU as well to the 4790K, and I upgraded a 980 Ti. This one I call the Mjolnir Messerschmitt. I don't know why, but I like naming my computers in a very unique and weird name. After that, as the channel grew, I experimented with a lot of stuff. My first one was scrap metal. All of the parts here were presumably dead from eBay, so the motherboard, RAM, CPU and cooler were like for parts, but I got them and they worked. Then all of the contents I put it in a drawer, made scrap metal V2. Can't remember why I did that, but hey ho. And then finally, I made it in V3, which was like Jonesbow J1 case, and wanted to use like a riser card to put a GTX 650 in it, but it didn't pan out as I intended, so moved on. The next one was Blast from the Past V1. In this one I went all in. As you can see, a three-way SLI 8800 GTX. I think I had the Q6600, 8GB of RAM, and a Corsair 850W TX2, I think. Then this build became quad SLI setup with two GTX 295s, which was mad. Then the CPU was the QX9650. V3 was another experimentation. I think I just changed the case and the video cards. Here we have a quad SLI of two 9800 GX2s. Then the next build I made for my roommate at that time, Battle Brother. Again, I made this computer for him specifically to play Witcher 3 when it came out, because me and him, we took holidays so we can just finish the game for like 2 weeks non-stop, we just played it. In here I think I got him like 16 gigs of RAM. The CPU was an i7-2600K and the video card was the Gigabyte G1970, which he still has to this day and still kicks ass. Then Crash Tester V5, when I started to experiment with the X58 platform. In here we have a Xeon CPU, the equivalent of the 9800X, which was the X5680, I think. A 6-core, 12-core CPU. I had like 12GB of RAM, the Crucial Ballistic Tracers one, and I don't know how I managed to squeeze in that big tower of a cooler, but hey-ho. Crash Tester became Extreme Tester. As you can see, I managed to find like two 780 Lightning cards, which I really love. They were so rare, so big, so over the top, so they were perfect for my build. Here I had the Kraken X52 as the cooler, and I used some of the G-Skill RAM that I really love, the Trident X's. I also covered it for a few episodes on the channel. I think I had the 6-core 390-30K, the 6-core 12-threaded CPU, yeah, and an Asus X79 Formula motherboard. Then finally I started to modify basically the clip that put me on the map when I did the judge build, where I took the Dana4 case, modify it, basically made it in a V2, so you can accept the Asetek 545 LC cooler in it. It was special because I managed to use like 32 gigs of RAM, the ASRock X99 ITX motherboard, so I can put the 5960X CPU in there, so it was like over the top. Where I'd reuse the 980 Ti, later upgraded to the GTX 1070 because it was more power efficient. Then another computer that I really loved was the Silent Giant, where I basically had the Threadripper generation in it, the 1900X, but still it was really cool. Upgraded to the 1060 GTX Strix card, the 3-fan one, had like 32 gigs of RAM from Crucial Ballistics DDR4, and the famous Asus Zenith motherboard, so yeah, really cool computer. Okay, moving on, I think this was my last year Christmas episode where I got my hands on a Dell XPS 720, the H2C one with the, like those hybrid custom water cooling freezer type things for the CPU. Massive computer, really loved it, full of personality. Basically it rumbles, it's like an American V8 when you start it up. Ah, such a cool computer. Then my main computer became the Exo. I named it because it was like an exoskeleton theme. I managed to combine like some old style parts with newer generation. So I had like a Thermaltake T3 open frame case. I had like a 1.5 kilowatt power supply. I had the 980X overclocked to 4.5 gigahertz. I think that was like a deep cool Captain 280 all-in-one cooler, and reused some of that Crucial Ballistics DDR3 RAM. One of my all-time best builds I think I ever did. And then later I managed to upgrade it to 48 gigabytes of RAM, despite the fact officially they only did for 24. And now we get to the final computer, which is the long-lasting Dana4 V4 upgraded to the Ryzen AMD platform, which I call Ryzen Judge. The crown jewel of course are the RAM, the G-Skill Trident Z Royale Silver in 32 gigs. I call them Crystal Meth or Swarovski because that's how they look. Still have the old power supply, the SFX Corsair 600 watts, and I upgraded lately the video card to the EVGA 1080 for the Win Edition, the one with 10 phases VRM, which is one hell of a video card for me and for my needs. The CPU, I have the 2700 because that's the only one I can cool with the Noctua L9A, the black one. So there you have it guys. Again, Merry Christmas to everybody. Thank you again for supporting me and watching my channel. And leave a comment down below, please, with your most, let's say, famous computer build that you had that you missed the most. So yeah, thank you again. Alex out.